Well, look at this story. Elon Musk is getting his kicks out of the Tesla's new semi-truck. He got thunderous applause for it. It's an all-electric big rig with the ability to carry up to 80,000 pounds. Now, Elon Musk touting that the new truck boasts a range of up to 500 miles per charge. To charge, it takes the truck up to 30 minutes to fill up at a high-end power station, all electric. Now, production on the truck slated to begin in 2019. Take a check of Tesla stock closing the day in the green, up almost a percent. With me now, we've got seasoned truck driver Matthew Garnett. Good to see you, Matthew. Okay, blow this story out of the water. Does this stack up, this Tesla electric truck?
No, it does not, Liz. I mean, first of all, Musk is motivated by his environmental agenda. And as long as that's the case, I don't trust it. Give me an outfit like Cummins or Peterbilt or somebody that would come out with a truck like this, and I might trust it. But coming from this guy, no way.
Okay, so he's saying, Elon Musk, that the truck takes a half hour to recharge, and the semis will travel 500 miles. But Matthew, you say it currently takes you only 10 minutes to fuel up, and you get 1,500 miles. So what do you say there?
Yeah, that's right. I mean, I fuel every few days. If I had to fuel every day, that would waste all kinds of time. So maybe that little bit of savings I'm getting in fuel efficiency is going to be wasted on all that time I'm spending charging the batteries back up. 500 miles is nothing for a truck.
And can I tell you something? The back end of the story is not being covered. The U.S. power grid is so rickety and arthritic, we don't know if it can handle charging so many electric cars and trucks. What doesn't Silicon Valley understand about your trucking industry?
Well, look, they're talking about putting all these charging stations everywhere, and, you know, the roads are terrible. We can't even get the roads right. Like you said, the power grid is rickety right now. And they're talking about putting all this infrastructure in. It's not going to happen. I mean, Congress can't even find their behind with both hands long enough to repeal Obamacare for me. This is just not going to happen.
I hear what you're saying. It's a great point you make because Tesla exists off of government subsidies. So, but your point is that this is what happens when new products from flawed global warming theory is put out there in the marketplace. Can you explain that?
Well, I mean, he's motivated by his environmental agenda, not by making truck driving easier, not by making the trucking industry more profitable. None of that is what's motivating him primarily. And so as long as that is his agenda, then the product is going to suffer.
You know, so here's the things. I think trucking, one stat has it, it's a $700 billion a year industry. There are about 4 million big rig trucks on the road hauling all U.S. goods. They run a lot of them on diesel engines. I mean, he's saying it's going to be less expensive to operate a Tesla electric truck than a diesel. Do you think he's right? Is it accurate?
No, he's not. Because, look, I mean, I don't think you have to put on your tinfoil hat to realize that this whole environmental agenda is a strike against capitalism. And the left likes to say capitalism is this big evil, but capitalism is what has brought the world joy, freedom, and prosperity. Throughout time, really, you know, as compared to the rest of human history. And what brings people joy and freedom and prosperity is trucks. And if you start monkeying around with that, then that's what you're monkeying around with at the end of the day.
We love common sense talk from Matthew Garner. Always terrific to have you on the show. We love having you on. And happy Thanksgiving, sir. Good to see you.